5 ghosts caught on camera. The Man in Black. So about a month ago, I featured a video from a YouTube urban exploration channel called Finders Beepers History Seekers. The really compelling thing about their creepy video was that the two hosts, Matt and Andy, are definitely not ghost hunters. In fact, they're complete skeptics. They simply caught a very strange occurrence during one of their urban explorations.
You see it goes up again. Hey, wait up. Hello? Somebody up there. Hello? I've gone cold because I saw somebody stood there. I saw a leg.
But there's one more very strange urban exploration video that the Finders Beepers guys recorded all the way back in 2017. A video that they were never able to explain. So, the Finders Beepers guys are exploring a long abandoned historic farm in Doncaster, England that is estimated to have been built sometime in the 1800s. Local legend says that the previous owner of the land allegedly took his own life by tying a rope around a solid beam inside one of the buildings. In the Finders Beepers video, it's clear that the two friends are pretty carefree and having a good time while exploring the empty farm.
So, Andy has literally just almost died. I'm just going to carry on filming you a minute, just because I have a feeling you're going to fall. And I want to get you on you being framed.
Don't really matter to me. You know, I'm not remain.
Go on. Go on. Go on. Just to show you where he would have fallen. Oh, Andy, I can see something good already. It's our good old favourite. It's the cellar.
I think it's going to be a bit of a tight squeeze down here.
Only for you, Paul.
And I do apologise, viewers, if you get to see my arse for about the millionth time.
It's become a regular occurrence. Bit of a celebrity, I think, got arse now, Matt, to be honest.
Yeah. Oh, God.
Oh, there it is, look. Full moon. My part moon.
Oh, dear. What the friggin' hell is going on here? Jesus Christ. Scared me to death.
Now, after Matt and Andy uploaded the video of their new exploration to their YouTube channel, it was no longer a joking matter. They were shocked by the comments from many concerned viewers. Because you see, someone or something at the abandoned farm seems to have been watching them. Something they didn't see. Watch the footage closely.
We've just made our way back down there, back through the beams, where all the pan tiles are. I'm going to quickly show Andy the kestrel, and then we'll make our way around. There should have been some massive buildings up that side. But so yeah, it's just a bit further up there.
Did you see it? The two friends are completely unaware as something seems to be staring at them from inside a room in the crumbling farmhouse. The figure appears to be wearing a dark suit, and its face is just a featureless black blur. A little later, Matt and Andy actually explore the same area where the dark figure was seen, but there's no one there. However, when they come back out, their footage shows something absolutely chilling.
They're becoming more and more of a liability.
Right. Let's go
to the main house, I think.
The mysterious faceless apparition of a man seems to have somehow now moved to where Matt and Andy had just been standing only minutes before. Again, it seems to watch the two unsuspecting explorers from afar. The guys claimed that they had no idea that they were being watched and didn't see anyone at the time of the recording. Let me say again that both Matt and Andy are skeptics when it comes to the paranormal. In fact, Andy flat out says that he just doesn't believe in ghosts. But they say that this creepy event has, quote, freaked us out a bit. So what do you think the Finders Beepers guys captured on camera? Could it be the spirit of the previous owner who allegedly took his own life at the farm? Or could it be some mysterious lurker without a face? Let me know what you think. You can watch this full video and others over on Matt and Andy's Urban Exploration channel, Finders Beepers, History Seekers. The Curse. Russian ghost hunter Tim Marazov travels deep into the secluded Russian countryside to investigate an abandoned house that is said to have been cursed by an evil witch. In his video, Tim tells the story of two mushroom pickers who were wandering the countryside one day and stumbled upon the completely boarded up house. They heard loud sounds coming from inside, and worried that someone might be in danger, they smashed their way inside. They were shocked when they were greeted by a strange dark shadow enveloped by a thick fog. They ran from the house. Tim says the couple later contacted him to investigate the creepy home. Upon entering the empty and decaying house, strange things immediately begin to happen.
Сама она тарелка упасть точно не могла. Фонарик у меня на столе был, кровать заправлял. Упала тарелка, не знаю, как она могла упасть. В принципе, никакая крыса, никакая мышь ее толкнуть не могла. И в темноте я, ну, дышал и увидел пар. Не знаю, было ли видно это на камеру.
After light bulbs start swinging on their own and a plate suddenly falls onto the floor, Tim explains he saw a strange fog or mist, which sounds eerily similar to what the mushroom-picking couple had reported. Tim is a little on edge, but decides to lay down on the bed and rest in the darkness while all of his devices and camera equipment are turned on and recording. What happens next is just truly bizarre. Tim's equipment experiences strange high-frequency feedback, and then all of a sudden, the Polaroid camera that he brought with him on the investigation suddenly snaps a photo all on its own. But what makes this footage even stranger is something you perhaps didn't see at first. So I have to ask, did you see it? As Tim is lying on the bed, a creepy-looking hand comes from the ceiling as if to grab him. Right before the hand reaches him, the Polaroid camera snaps a photo and the hand disappears. Tim has no idea what he just captured, but is baffled either way by the strange Polaroid snapshot. Trying to explain the incident to himself, he says that the Polaroid could have possibly just malfunctioned because of the intense humidity inside the house. But then things get stranger and even more terrifying.
Я не знаю, друзья, может быть, просто из-за сырости в этом доме что-то у нее замкнуло. Сырости в этом доме. Что-то у нее замкнуло. Слушай.
again. Did you see it? Captured on the camera that is recording Tim's laser grid, you can see a dark shadow figure trying to open the door by moving the door handle. It then once again disappears into thin air. Tim carefully checks out the door and looks inside the room on the other side, but there's just no one there. A week goes by, and after reviewing all of the chilling evidence he captured on camera, he returns to the cursed abandoned house once more. Tim soon realizes that he might have made a huge mistake.
Ее тут точно не было. 100%. Блин, струнник. Брат-то. Кто там? Кто там? Ты кто? Ответь! Кто ты? Там ног нет. Кто ты? Возможно. Твою мать.
Tim is shocked. First, he hears something fall onto the floor and is lured into the home's living room. As he leaves, a shadow figure can be seen on the wall behind him, watching him as he leaves before disappearing. Tim then sees a bottle lying on the floor that he is sure wasn't there before. When he inspects the bottle, something seems to move into the curtain right next to him. The shape almost seems like someone invisible is standing against the curtain. Then when the shape suddenly retreats, Tim quickly opens the curtain to find absolutely nothing.
Пипец, друзья, просто дико страшно. Такое чувство, что сзади просто кто-то наблюдает, я не знаю.
Tim explains that he is getting very scared now, and as he talks to the camera, a shadow can be seen quickly darting from right to left in the mirror right behind him. He says he feels that someone is watching him, and soon after, a chair mysteriously slides across the floor all on its own. Then as he checks his equipment, the chair falls over and a rope hanging from the ceiling can be seen swaying back and forth. After all of this terrifying activity that he caught on camera, Tim finally decides to just get out of there. So did Tim Marzov capture what locals claim to be a supernatural curse on this house? Did he encounter the sinister presence of whoever used to live in the now abandoned home? Or is it something even darker? As always, you decide. You can check out the full 3-part series of The Cursed House and many more scary paranormal videos over on Tim Morozov's YouTube channel. Before we move on to the next video, if you see anything that you think should be included in the top 5, contact us at nukestop5@gmail.com, the mysterious Mackey Mansion. Paranormal investigators Matt Benton from the YouTube channel Devil's Hour Productions and Dante Reeder from the channel Soul Seekers investigate the mysterious haunting of the Mackey Mansion in Virginia City, Nevada. The mansion was built in 1859 by the infamous Hearst family and is one of the only remaining historical structures to have survived 2 major fires in Virginia City. The Victorian building was later owned by silver mining millionaire John Mackey, after whom the building is named. At the beginning of the evening, investigator Dante and guest Violet head off to a nearby cemetery, leaving Matt from Devil's Hour Productions all alone inside the mansion. As he is doing a preliminary check of the house, Matt starts to get some very unexpected activity. Matt decides to do a spirit box session, and he's descending the mansion staircase when he captures something very disturbing. Matt says he could see something out of the corner of his eye, and upon reviewing his footage, he discovers that he captured a partial apparition. Now, it's a little hard to see as the camera unexplainably loses focus just as Matt captures the apparition. But when the clip is slowed down, you can clearly see some kind of figure quickly moving out of sight just as Matt turns the corner at the bottom of the stairs. Even more bizarre, whatever this is seems to disappear right into the solid wall at the side of the staircase. Later in the evening, Matt, Dante, and Violet conduct a spirit box session upstairs in what used to be John Mackey's bedroom. And then, this happens.
Good job, that's exactly what we want.
What we all just heard was a loud bang right behind Dante. And when we looked in the direction to where we heard the bang, we all realized the wardrobe was partially open. Before the bang even happened, the wardrobe was completely closed. I even checked inside to see if I could debunk the wardrobe opening all by itself, but I didn't see anything that could make that happen. Less than 1 minute after the bang happens, we capture a shadow figure on the right side of the screen. It is hard to see, so look very closely.
Matt from Devil's Hour Productions wants to push the investigation even further. He decides to sit down on John Mackey's bed in hopes of invoking Mackey's ghost. It did not go well.
Huh? I'm laying in your bed.
Mr. Mackey, you're gonna have to show him. He's laying in your bed, you're gonna have to show him that you're the boss. Something's hot on my back, man. Oh, shit.
He's agitated.
Look up here.
Can you record?
It's on this side. Don't even tell me.
Yep, we got one.
Oh, God.
Don't even tell me, man.
Yeah, hold on one second. I need to take off my shirt.
Yo. What is it?
It's a scratch.
It's one big scratch.
It's thick.
It's a burn mark.
While Matt is taunting John Mackey's spirit, it is actually Dante who receives a large scratch on his back. So did Matt from Devil's Hour Productions provoke the spirit of whomever or whatever is haunting the Mackey Mansion? Did the group capture evidence of John Mackey's spirit still roaming his beloved estate? Let me know your thoughts down in the comments. You can check out this full video and more investigations over on the YouTube channel, Devil's Hour Productions. The Lady in Red. Popular Chinese ghost hunter Xiao Long and his friend Lao Dai are back with another live adventure in one of China's many creepy and mysteriously abandoned places. This time they explore what they believe to have been a massive government building that might be haunted by a vengeful female spirit. The creepy long dark hallways would give anyone major anxiety. But Lao Dai doesn't seem to be bothered by any of it, sticking his hands in places where they don't belong, literally.
别鸡巴动了。我操你妈！哎呦我操你大爷！你妈逼吓我一跳你！我给你摆那逼玩意儿呢，我给你摆。这啥玩意儿呢？这是？那是号夹子吧？夹着手的东西啊？
Lao Dai blindly sticks his hand into a bucket and startles Xiao Long as he clumsily pulls back with a mouse trap clamped onto his fingers. Xiao Long simply laughs at him, and the two friends carry on their investigation. However, this isn't the only time Lao Dai fools around in the dark. Lao Dai attempts to scare Xiao Long, with a fart. But it doesn't work. But soon after, something terrifies them both.
在风雨学上来讲，四就是死，所以说四。
Lao Dai claims he heard something, and at first Xiao Long just doesn't believe him. But then they both get startled by a loud sound coming from somewhere in the large empty building. Now, the two investigators are done with jokes, and they proceed with caution. When they reach a higher floor and enter one of the creepy empty rooms, things take a turn towards the truly chilling. When looking into the reflection of a window, Xiao Long spots a mysterious figure in red standing in the doorway right behind them. When he quickly turns around, there's no one there. So he hurries around the corner to find whoever or whatever he saw but doesn't find anyone. He looks into the window's reflection once again. Now there's nothing there, and he proves that it was not an optical illusion. Xiaolong and Lao Dai no longer feel that they are alone, and begin to worry that they are possibly being stalked by the vengeful female spirit that is said to haunt the building, the Lady in Red. Only minutes later, and the two ghost hunters get such a terrifying fright that they run for their lives. After hearing loud, unexplained sounds coming from all around them, the two decide to split up and both record using their own phone. Lao Dai captures something so terrifying that he has had enough and wants to just get out of there. Once safely back in the car, Lao Dai shares his creepy footage with Xiaolong and the livestream audience.
我一旦别给我画眼，哎呦我操！完了，我腿都软了。哎，我操你妈！快开呀！哎呦我操！这是我一说，这啥二呢？哎呦我，就是窗户开那屋，哎呦我，哎呦我，这他妈有啥呀？ 就这块，就这块！我操！啥？哎呦，我操你妈！
So did Lao Dai capture the sinister spirit of a woman out for revenge? Or is it all just an elaborate hoax? You decide. You can watch Xiaolong's entire exploration and many more creepy videos over on his YouTube channel, Xiaolong Adventure. 911. TikTok user Brandy Nicole works at a 911 emergency dispatch center in Georgia. She claims that over the 6 years she has worked there, strange things like unexplained noises and things falling off the walls are a regular occurrence. However, recently the creepy activity seems to have intensified for no apparent reason. Brandy begins to secretly record her experiences and carefully shares her captures on TikTok.
So I'm just sitting at work and I hear things fall in the lobby. Not sure. And the lights are off. They were on. Oh, and they're on now. All right, yeah, I'm gonna be done with that. Nope, I'm done. Oh, what was that? So I'm at work again. Holter's acting up as we're now referring to her. Maybe it's somebody. I don't know. Nobody should be here. There's literally no one here. Oh.
Now, it's common for 911 workers in smaller towns to work overnight shifts alone. And Brandy claims she is completely alone and has no explanation for any of the strange things happening on her job.
So, since y'all thought I was doing the lights, let me show you these. This one does nothing. This one turns on this extra light. So.
Then late one night, the strange activity at Brandy's job takes a terrifying turn.
So, y'all have been following my Poulter diaries here lately. So I'm pretty sure there's something standing in the doorway to the break room. Am I crazy, or is that somebody standing there? Do y'all see that?
What appears to be the silhouette of someone's shoulder can be seen sticking out from a doorway. At first, Brandy's not quite sure what it is, but then when the mysterious silhouette moves away, Brandy screams. She explains in her comments that she called an officer to check the building, but he found no one inside and nothing that could explain the strange silhouette.
Hey guys, this is just an update to let you all know that I'm okay. Back at work today, but I'm no longer working by myself. I have someone here with me. Everything's been fine so far. We haven't had anything today, so. And here we go. What was that? What? It came from the hallway. Oh my God. No.
So is the 911 emergency dispatch center that Brandy works at haunted? Or is it all just an elaborate hoax? You decide. Thanks so much for watching. Please follow me on Instagram right there if you want to. And also on Twitter right there. You can find channel updates and some random weird videos on both. I'll see you all next week.